People left 8 o'clock from Bangladesh. Then we arrived here 7 o'clock this morning. We went to the human rights place.
On s'est rassemblés, réfugiés et soutien sur la place des droits de l'homme sur le boulevard Mohamed V. Jusqu'à ce que la police dise à tout le monde de partir.
Je vis en ce moment dans le camp de Choucha comme les autres. Dans le camp de Choucha, il y a beaucoup de nationalités là-bas qui ont été rejetées. Ce que leur demande d'asile a été rejeté par le bureau des Nations Unies à Choucha, opérant actuellement à Choucha. Nous tous, nous sommes sortis de la crise libyenne. Et aujourd'hui, on est considéré par le bureau des Nations Unies comme rejeté. Donc, selon nous, on se dit qu'on n'est pas rejeté. Tout compte fait, nous tous, on est sorti de la crise libyenne et qu'on ne sait pas où aller.
J'ai 3 enfants et جوزي مفقود. وعدوني ريجكت يعني مصيري شنو عارفه. عندي 3 أولاد مصيري شنو هذا أصغر. واحد والثانيين كلهم صغار عمر 13 و14 مصير شنو يعني ما عارفه مصير شنو وتعبانين في شوشة تعب يعني تعبانين حالة نفسية جاتنا مرضانين وديما يعني مفكر بروحي في الخيمة لو في الليل ما برقد نهار ما برقد في الليل بخاف يقول بيجي علي حاجة لصغاري.
Et ce qu'on veut seulement, on appelle l'opinion nationale si quelqu'un pouvait nous venir en aide.
Right now we are in the UNHCR office, United Nations office, in Tunis. Of course, for now we've never seen nobody, but we're waiting for them. We're waiting for them. Already we are in front of their compound. So we're waiting for them. Every one of us. We volunteer at this particular moment to wait for them, for our rights. We die slowly, and for us to keep dying slowly for our rights, we decided to come out and do this peaceful protest so that the international world and those that are responsible for our future can come together and think about it, because they say human rights is existing. So we believe it would be nice for them to prove the right that they're talking about, which is human right.
Yesterday night, the rain was drizzling. It was horrible and challenging, but we don't have any option. We don't have any alternative. We are pushed to the road, so we passed the night here in the cold. We only try to organize ourselves in the sense that our first priority, like those that we have to consider, the kids and the women. Then for the rest of us, we already know how to manage the situation. Early this morning, one of the UNHCR representatives, Mr. Meji, he called 3 of us in to have a closed-door meeting with us. But you know, normally we had some certain demands that we made to him, but his response was that the UNHCR has nothing, absolutely, that they remain their position and nothing is going to change. So to that effect, we decided that if not until the demands are met, we are not going to leave this place, because we have nowhere to go back to.